All right, we're ready to continue on with this. I've drawn my lines for my lid, my spout, and the two holes that we're going to be drilling for our bale where we're going to put the wire. First thing I want to do now, though, is go ahead and carve this line around here. So just kind of slant your knife, because you're cutting down into the end grain. And that's not the easiest thing to do. Now go back the opposite way. Real careful. Or even with that spigot. Cutting up to it because I want the lid to be just a little bit larger than the pot beneath. There's my line marker there, I think. Let's see if we can carve one more. Be careful with this one, because you don't want to bother that first ridge. So I don't get ahead of myself. let's do this one. Slant your knife inward away from the outer edge. Come up here and bring the point up. What you want is you want to try to get a whole chip out of there. Hear that snap? Just like that. Now you can go back and clean it up if you'd like. As you cut these, see how the chip goes in? What you want to do is relax that, so it looks more natural. See, like that. With your other line over there. And like I say, go back and relax that edge you carved off so it looks natural. Down just a little up here. A lot better. pretty good. So let's reestablish our holder here. That's there. Now you want to get your, want to get these things right both ways so they look natural. You don't want one side up and one side down and one side back and the other side forward. You want to get it square because that's the way the real pot is. Okay, so now we're finished with our coffee pot. The carving part anyway. So now we're going to shift positions here and head over to the old carving station and do these things and make some little metal things that'll go on there, all right? Okay, we're over here at the old carving station. Now what I'm going to do here is first I'm going to drill a couple holes into the side of the coffee pot up here where those inserts are going to go to hold the handle, all right? And then we'll work on the rest of it, okay? So let's do that first on the drill down here. I'm going to use a piece of 3/16 inch dowel to make these two little inserts. And we'll also use this dowel to make the handle of the coffee pot. So the first thing I'm going to, I've picked me a smaller drill here because I want to pre-drill the hole. Just to make sure. Make sure it's all lined up. Okay, now I can change my drill and get me a 3/16 drill. Having that pilot hole drill sure makes it easier when you're drilling your other holes. So let's take this, cut us off a couple small little chunks. Put them in here temporarily to see that everything matches up here. Looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. So what I'm going to do now is, well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put those in there. I'm going to tap them down to about where I want them. Go! Hang on here. Let's see, this tapped it in there too far. Thank God. All right, that's about right. Don't worry about that fuzz. Now, I'm gonna take me some super glue. And if I put a drop there on the end of that, toothpick. Just the natural capillary action of the dowel will draw this super glue down inside and will anchor that thing in place. And I'll just take some of this excess here and work it around the edge just to be positive. Alright, and then I'm going to take my accelerator and just give it a quick little spritz, and that'll set that glue off almost immediately. Now I can take my knife and come here and just go around and get rid of the fuzzies there. That glue's already set up. Now the last thing there is what I want to do is get rid of this. And I've got some ...18-gauge wire, galvanized wire here. You can buy that down at the home store. I got a short one too. This is what I'm going to be making my bale out of for the pot. So what I want to do is find me a drill the same size as this. Which I don't have. Here's a little tip. Here's a nail. Now this nail, not sure what size it is. It's probably just a brad nail like that. Just snip the head off of it. See, it's just a little bit larger, but it'll work fine. So I'm just going to chuck this in, and it'll be my drill. Find the center of the dowel, right there. So there, drill's a perfect hole. Let's set that aside. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to anchor a little piece of strap on the back there. That's this thing right here. Now I'm going to make mine a little larger than that. This is some just galvanized tin. This is roof flashing, step flashing they call it. It's just a little angle thing. You can find it down at the home center. Lowe's, Home Depot, Lumberyard, whatever. You want to cut you off a piece that looks good. You just sort of have to guesstimate it. That looks good. Someone asked me on the blog, well, how do you determine the size of your coffee pot? How big it should be in relationship to your character? Well, I'm assuming that you have your character, or you have a pattern for your character. And although this one here in this photograph is a lot larger in scale to the actual one here, remember it's caricature carving, so you're allowed a little latitude, and we're emphasizing the cook and his coffee pot, so it's okay if you make it a little larger because that makes it more visible. So that's what we're doing. So let's get on with this thing. Cut my end square here. I want to make a little tab right here. I'll just bend that up like that. Then I want to make another little tab. You'll see what I'm doing here. Bend that like that. See there? Can you see what I did there? And I'm going to hold that up to my pot here. Figure out how wide I want it, which is about right there. And bend that down. And come back up out here. Well, I'm just going to leave that right there. You want it about the same distance as that one over there. And then bend this one up like that. Okay, so now we've got... we've got that. So now I just need to cut this side off to match the other side, which is about right there. Okay? Just like that. Now, to anchor it on there, this is just a shop awl here. You could use a compass point or whatever. Find your spot on here. What we're going to do is make two holes. There's one. And there's two. We'll make this one a little larger. Alright, now I'm going to use... Judy's probably trying to follow me with the camera. I'm going to use just some small escutcheon, I guess that's how you pronounce it, brads. So they just have a little round top. You can find these at Hobby Lobby or in the home center. And you notice it won't go through there? Well, it will go through there in just a second. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this over to my little disc sander over here. Belt sander, actually. And I'm going to round these two points here on each corner. I don't need to show you how to do that. And I'm going to take this on the sander and I'm going to touch this side. See how it's punched out there? I'm going to take that on the sander and just sand that off. And that will enlarge this hole enough to where that brad will fit in it. Let's bend that straight, okay? So I'll go do that. Okay, I've got... sanded the back edges off, and as you can see, the nails just fall right in there like that. Now see, that gives us a real pleasing appearance when we get it all together. I'm sure this one fits too. Oh, that little booger. I'm going to take another cap here. Okay, now we got that done, so we want to bend these things just a little in like that. See how I did that? And then I'm going to kind of bend this one like that. This is to take into consideration the roundness back here. And then we're going to hold that in position, get it to where we want it, right in the middle. About right there. Pencil, pencil. We'll just make a little mark there. I think I'll only drill one hole at first, just so I don't goof up, okay? So let me find my drill for those little nails. It's a real small nail. You want it smaller than the shaft of the nail. Got a little sanding block I brought down the home center. what I'm going to do here is just sand off the top of this nail. That way, paint will stick to it. So it's been brass coated, so we'll get rid of that brass coating. We'll position that thing right there. Side. Still loose. There we go. So now if I can go ahead and drill them another hole. Off my nail. Bingo. Got that strap on there. Looks good, huh? All right, let's check out this. We need a top for our coffee pot, so let's just cut off another strip here. Judy's giving me instructions here. I'll just cut it the same size as the other one. Now this one will do it a little bit different. Let's put this in here about like that. Now you can make it like this here if you want it. That one got a little bent when I was nailing it. There. I'll make it about there. I'm going to bend that side down, bend that side down. Like that. Well, I actually should have done it another way. Bend that back up. Bend that down like that. Bend this up like that. I'll go back up here. Bend that down like that. You might be witnessing a big screw up right here. I hope not. Distance is the other one. Bend that back like that. I hope not. I'm going to bend this one back like that. We put everything together. See what we got. That looks pretty good. There, can you see what it did there? Okay, now what I want to do is I want to put this up top here. I have to figure out which way I want it. Well, I want to open. I don't want it visible to the viewer like this because all they see is that. What I want to do is have it open to where they can see through the bail or the handle. It'll look better that way. So I'm going to make me a little mark right here. Now right there is where I want that. And I want to turn on my burning tool. Let it get hot. And here's the handle of the coffee pot. just another piece of 3/16 inch dowel. And I got my drill here, I'll go ahead and crawl around and find it finish. Hopefully I won't grow my fingers. Looks good. I'm going to take this little drill out of here. Change up to a bigger drill. Now this drill is larger than that wire. Very carefully. I'm going to drill each way and hopefully meet in the middle. Without going through my fingers. Come on, go through there! Let's go through the other way, I guess. I thought I'd drill farther. Well, this is gonna... There we go. Finally. The wire goes through there. Yep, goes through there flies. Okay. So my glue. Hot iron must be hot by now. It is. So I'm going to just burn me a hole down through the center here. As Judy pushes my head out of the way. Snip this off because I don't need that much. Going down in there. And burn it just a little bit more. Now I'll get my super glue. Put a good drop in there. Let it sink down, fill up that hole. I don't want that, do I? And we'll put that in there. Never to come out again. It's kind of twisted that way. Let's turn it around the other way before the glue sets up. Yeah, that's better. And there we have the lid. Okay? Now, the only thing left to do is to put this handle on. You can see how I'm doing this. I don't, well, here, let me go ahead and show you. First, you want to get your wire probably where it's straightened out. Like that. Now, if you're going to have your coffee pot just standing on its own, you can just go ahead and, you know, bend these down, bend them around, and put a little L on the bottom of them here. Like that, to where it'll go into your little doohickey there. Hopefully you'll have a drill that you can use. And then you bend it to shape, you know, and you just let it drop. If you want it to fall down where it hits about right there. Now if you're going to put it on a figure, well then you're talking about a whole different ball of wax. So first off, this is demonstration purposes here. First off, we have to have a figure. Well, and it just so happens that I have one around here somewhere. There it is. So, he's got a lantern up here. I'm going to tell you about that lantern here in a minute. His handle is going to go right into his hand like that. So we can, you're doing this at the very end. This is probably the last thing you will do is put on the lantern and the coffee pot. So you want to hook this in here like this, get your wire in there. Stick that in there like that. As soon as you get it in there, just kind of guesstimate it and then bend it down. Okay? Careful. Because you certainly don't want to reach that point where everything is critical. Now we want to figure out exactly where our pot's going to look. Pretty good. I bent that pretty good. So I'm going to turn that around like that. Got the handle in his hand. I could have actually had a larger piece of wire. So let me just grab that right there and bend it this way. Oh, that'll be okay. Okay. You want to make sure your bends on your handle are the same on each side. And it's still not. Then you take your coffee pot. Judy's giving me instructions again, which I don't know what she's trying to tell me. Bend those out. Here, let me turn it around here. Maybe that's what she's trying to tell me. Put it in one side. You want your spout out that direction. Then we'll bend this other one in this direction. You can see why you do this at the last step, because you're going to glue those things in there and they're never going to come out again. But because we drilled that hole all the way through, you don't want to glue the wire to the handle, because we want this coffee pot. Don't swing much, but we want it to swing because that's a natural thing. And there he is. Let's see how much that shows up here. And he's out there, it's early morning out there on the prairie somewhere with the cowboys and the chuck wagon. He's got his coffee pot ready to go. And there's coffee in it, I guess I should have said that. He's got the coffee ready, and it's time to wake those boys up and get them to work. So anyway, the next thing to do now, boy, we fixed that just perfectly where that hangs down below his apron. So the next thing is to paint this pot, and that's what we'll do in the next video.